Live at Madison Square Garden, it's New York Rangers hockey tonight. The Rangers take on the Boston Bruins. Hello, everyone, and welcome to New York Rangers Hockey. I'm Sam Rosen, along with John Davidson. Al Trotwig joins us a little later on. Rangers and Bruins, as we mentioned, always something special, John.
Well, certainly in looking back during the game, the first game of the season between these two clubs, that was certainly a good one, a 2-2 tie in which Boston came back late. Yes, it's been a past history of great games, and the Rangers actually need a great game right here tonight to get back on track.
They really do. They've lost two in a row. Defensively, they've had some problems, so they make a little change. Sergei Zubov returns from Binghamton.
You know, when he played with the Rangers earlier, you could see what the record was. He was sent down. The coaches had smiles on their faces knowing that Zubov had played very well and knowing that when he was about to be recalled, they could recall him and know what they're going to get, a guy that can play in the National Hockey League. Rangers have had trouble getting out of their zone as a unit. No one in particular to be blamed, but they're hoping Zubov can help with the first pass, the quick pass out of the zone, and maybe help quarterback the power play. Here you see him moving up against Toronto on the power play, smart, heady player. And the Rangers need that right now.
All right, another man they need up front is Jan Eriksson. He's missed the last 19 games. He's missed 24 games this season, and the Rangers are really happy to have him back.
Well, they certainly are, and he's healthy. He was out with a back problem, plus a hip flexor. No strength in the leg. He's worked hard to get back and get strong again for plays like this. He's a diligent, hard-working individual, perhaps the most underrated defensive forward in the league. The Rangers last season, fourth overall in goals against. As of right now, they're 15th. There has to be more diligence and more respect paid by the Rangers team to defensive play if they're to get back winning.
Those two are not the only lineup changes tonight. The Rangers making several changes. Take a look. Who's out? Hardy, Sorella, Chris King, Steve King, Paul Broughton, and Mike Richter, who started last night. Who's in? Sergei Zubov, Kevin Lowe back from the flu, Jan Eriksson, Phil Bourque, Randy Gillen, and John Van Beesbrouck gets the start and goal.
Well, we're certainly talking about changes, five changes aside from the goaltenders, and this, you know, includes all different positions. You're going to see Turcotte go up to the left side and play again with Messier and Amonte. Boston is not the big, bad Bruin team of the past. This is a very fast team, a team that can counter quickly. Rangers have lots of speed in there, and the players getting back into the lineup have a real good chance to show themselves right here.
And the Bruins have a great number one line. In fact, you could make an argument that this could be the best top line in the league.
The Bruins are 11 points ahead of last year's pace. That line is by far and away their best line. 142 points they've combined for. They can do everything. They can forecheck. They've got speed to counter with. They're good finishers. You see here this line work the wall. Now watch this. Bartolnov with a great pass in front. Junot along with Oates. They combine for offense and scoring. Remember, the Bruins have six first-year players in their lineup. Five of them rookies. Two of the rookies on that line with one of the great playmakers in the game today in Adam Oates. That line has to be taken care of.
All right, we'll see if the Rangers do take care of it. We'll be set to go with the opening faceoff. Second meeting of the season, Rangers and Bruins. This one at Madison Square Garden in just a moment. Back at Madison Square Garden, season's greetings to everyone. Hope you're enjoying the holiday season. Boston Bruins come in having won three in a row, winning in Hartford last night, 9-4. Andy Moog, carrying the load in goal, will be making his seventh consecutive start and his 12th in the last 13 games. Last night he made 16 saves. And there is Sergei Zubov, Rangers fifth round draft pick from last year, who stepped in and played in three winning games.
Played very well. He knows what to expect, and the Ranger coaches know what to expect from him.
Right now, we are set for the singing of our national anthem. Let's go to center ice and John Amaranti.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proud we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming. Steve! say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free? And the
gets a set, the packed house here at Madison Square Garden. Andy Moog.
Andy Moog with the win last night in Hartford had an outstanding third period in that game. The game was still close. He made three big saves, and his club went along and ended up beating Hartford 9-4.
John Van Biesbroek steps back in goal. He has won five of his last six, but the one loss, that tough overtime loss against the New Jersey Devils.
So you look at his last 10 games as a segment, he's won seven, lost two, tied one, and has played quite well. This should be an outstanding game. Lots of speed. You will see, as we said, as Paul Dvorsky gets ready, we will see Turcotte play the left side with Messier. We've got speed to burn all throughout this game.
Okay, tonight's overhead camera shot is brought to you by the Upper Deck Company. Nobody does hockey like Upper Deck. Rangers open with Doug Waite centering for Adam Graves on the left, Alexei Kovalov on the right, with Mike Hurlbutt and James Patrick on defense. And the Bruins counter with Dave Poulin, number 19, at center. Steve Leach, number 27, at right wing. Grigory Pantaleov, number 13, a rookie from the former Soviet Union. Dave Shaw, the former Ranger, number 34, on defense, along with Don Sweeney, number 32. Battle along the boards, Graves and Shaw. Sweeney has the puck. Poulin tries to clear, and does. Hurlbutt sending it the other way. Kovalov with a nice move away from Sweeney, then Poulin breaks it up. And icing is whistled against the Boston Bruins. Roger Nielsen changing things up after the two losses and a lot of goals against. And you see some of the moves. Randy Gillen back in at center. Phil Bourque, Jan Eriksson on the left side. Darren Turcotte moving to the left wing. On defense, Kevin Lowe back in after battling the flu. And Sergei Zubov back in with Mark Hardy and Joe Cirella scratch. John Van Biesbroek starting with Mike Richter backing up tonight. Brian Sutter in his first year as head coach of the Boston Bruins and doing a fine job, has his team 2 points behind first place Montreal in the Adams division.
And he has Rodney Danger. I mean, Tommy McGee is the assistant coach on the bench. You know, the Poulin line started, they went off. Now Roger Nielsen comes back with the Messier line to go opposite Hines. So what Roger Nielsen is trying to do here early, it appears, is to keep Messier's line away from Dave Poulin, who's a smart checking center iceman.
Our production crew did such a great job on the best of Tommy McVie. And I tell you, they could have made it a half hour show on that. Frank DeGrace doing a terrific job putting it together. And they could have done a half-hour special. He goes on and on and on.
And hardly any bleeps.
Messier with a steal, and it's forced out of the zone. Bukaboom and Lowe paired on defense. Messier, Turcotte, and Amonte up front for the Rangers. This is Tony Amonte moving in on Glenn Wesley, who chops at the stick and went on goal, and Moog's there to decide. Ted Donato, number 21, on the ice with Steve Hines, number 23. Brent Hughes, number 42. Glenn Wesley and Ray Bourque on defense. Wesley 26 and Bourque the familiar 77. Donato against Amonte. Two Massachusetts men battling there. Kevin Lowe looking at Donato. The pass across his tip comes out to Wesley for the shot. Save Van Biesbroek. The rebound stopped by Van Biesbroek. Lowe gains control. Rangers come out. Messier with Turcotte. Stopped at the line, Messier recovers in center.
I find it interesting that now with Adam Oates' line stepping on the ice, and oh, Messier flattened.
It's Brent Hughes. Now Bukaboom goes over and hits Hughes, and a shove and a punch.
There's a penalty coming up, and it all happened with a line change at the Boston bench. But I found it interesting that Bourque was not on the ice with the Oates line. You would think that that would be the unit of five. However, we will have our first penalty minutes here. Messier was the original man to get the penalty. He leveled, I think, Hughes as Hughes was coming on the ice. Try and take a look at the line change of the Boston bench.
just to the left side. Messier cuts back with the puck. Oh, and he's hit by Hughes, I see. And it must have been a retaliation play where Messier went back at Hughes. Hughes cuts across, you see the hit. Two Bruins, oh, and there's the retaliation penalty. Action, reaction, Hughes with the action, Messier with the reaction. And this is a penalty the Rangers have to try and kill. Now, you might say, okay, bad penalty. But to me,
it's a 5-on-3. John Bukaboom got it too also. Oh, he went in there and gave Brent Hughes a shot also.
No, now it's problems. Now it's problems. Originally, I was going to say, yes, Messier takes a retaliation penalty. But, I mean, you've got to battle. I know you want to stay smart, but it's early in the game. You got to battle, and you got to get the team's intensity up. Yeah. And the Rangers need that. They need to play hard hockey. But now, in taking two penalties, now they're shorthanded two men for a full 2 minutes. You rethink of what your evaluation.
Well, I think Messier did what he had to do and took the penalty. Bukaboom's move, I think, was unnecessary.
Yeah, well, that's exactly right. That's exactly right.
It's a 5-on-3, and the Bruins send out their top line of Adam Oates, number 12, Dmitry Barkalnov, number 10, Joey Junot, number 49, Ray Bourque, number 77, with Ted Donato, number 21, playing the left point.
Well, number 12 has 12 power play goals. The ultimate playmaker leads with 12 goals.
Donato to Bourque for the shot. He shanked it. Barkalnov pushing it into the crease, and Van Beesbrouck covers up.
Now, last night, Hartford, in playing Boston, they stayed in the game as long as they could. What they tried to do was to keep Bourque and Oates from quarterbacking the puck up the ice. And what you do with Bourque, who's a left-handed shot playing right defense, is Hartford tried to stop Bourque from skating up the left side of the ice. They tried to force Bourque over to the right side, which will be the near side if you're looking at it television screen-wise. And therefore, he would have to make plays on the backhand side of his stick, which is tougher to do.
Rangers penalty killing 14th in the league. Bruins power play is 12th in the league, but they are 5-for-21 in their last three games. Bourque, Barkalnov in front for Oates. He just missed the redirection. What a pass by Barkalnov. Donato to Oates. Oates' last four goals have been on the power play, and 9 of his last 13. Oates for Junot, knocked down in front by Gillen, and he clears. So 5-on-3, Rangers had Gillen, Lowe, and Patrick on. Now Gillen goes off, and Erickson steps on. For the first time in a long time, Jan Erickson back on the ice. He had missed 19 consecutive games. 1 minute to go on the 5-on-3. Donato looking. Adam Oates to Ted Donato. Ray Bourque shoots it, blocked by Erickson. Barkalnov moves it for Oates. It goes past him. Junot against Erickson.
Look at that.
Erickson with a hard hit with a stick. Lost his stick.
Look at that.
Rangers clear.
That was a loose puck battle, and Jan Erickson beat Junot through the puck, through the body check, and the Rangers move the puck out of the zone. Erickson sparkling here for the Rangers.
Now Turcotte has come on with Wells and Zubov. 30 seconds to go. Around the board, stopped by Ted Donato. Moving in, he looks. Pass down low to Adam Oates. Back to Donato for the shot. Deflected over the top. Off the glass and around the Ray Bourque. Pressuring him is Turcotte to clear. 20 seconds to go.
And prior to Erickson making that play, he blocked the point shot. Erickson helping the Rangers with some life.
Barkalnov to Bourque for the shot. Wide. Bruins have not had a shot on goal on a 5-on-3, which has only 5 seconds remaining. Pass tipped by Zubov. Gillen couldn't control, but the power play is over. The teams are back at full strength. 4 minutes gone by in the first period. No score and great penalty killing by the Rangers. No shots on goal for the Bruins. A 2-minute 5-on-3. Messier finds Wells. Long pass to Amonte. Streaking down the right side. He goes in on Murphy. Amonte is in. He scores!
Oh, baby, what a goal! Tony Amonte's second shift. His first shift, he was flying. He's from Boston. You can see he wants to play well against the Bruins. What an outlet pass by the Rangers from behind their own goal. Tony Amonte absolutely flying. And what a finish! 1-0 Rangers after the penalty killing unit got it done. Look at the pass, diagonal pass. Amonte with his speed blows around the defense, top corner. Oh baby, it doesn't get any better than that. Tony Amonte knows he's got the defenseman beat, keeps the puck wide so he can't be checked
and goes top corner.
Man, what a play.
He loves that one. 100th career point in the NHL for the second year, man. Tony Amonte is 16th of the season from Wells and Messier. Amonte trying to get it away from Glenn Featherstone. Bruins come out with a puck. Hot to layoff. Carrying, Patrick breaks it up. Featherstone fires around the boards. 4:17, the time of the goal. The penalty killing, sparking the Rangers, and then Amonte flying in for the first goal of the game. Andrew McKim, number 45 on the ice, is just called up by the Bruins, and we have a whistle and a penalty. Pantaleoff and Hurlbut are separated.
Pantaleoff went right into Hurlbut, flattened him. Pantaleoff will be in the penalty box. Rangers power play when we come back.
Adam Graves and Don Sweeney going at it in center ice.
Kind of waited until Adam Graves runs into Featherstone. Graves gets good position here, drives Sweeney into the boards. That's a good solid hit. He got his body ahead of Sweeney. And once you're down on top of me, he has to rub it in a little, huh? Anyway, Featherstone is Graves' best buddy. They grew up together. And Featherstone plays it tough. Adam Graves plays it tough. And interesting to see if they collide a few times in this game.
Yeah. Don Sweeney is not a big guy, and he's been playing real tough. Had a good season. Gordon Murphy's pass is blocked.
Sam, the difference between that hit and the one on Zelopukin is that Adam Graves had his elbow down.
Turcotte got hit by Gordon Murphy, who's roughing up Turcotte right in front of Dvorsky, and they separate. Hurlbut's got the puck. 8 minutes to go in the first. Rangers leading 1-0 on a goal by Tony Amonte. Hurlbut going at it along the boards behind the play. And we have a whistle for a two-line pass. There was Darren Kimball, who was going at it with Mike Hurlbut. Ice hockey in Harlem auction Thursday, January the 7th from 6 to 9 p.m. at Sports on Broadway. Bruce Beck will be the auctioneer and host, and the Rangers due to appear. Jeff Bukaboo, Mike Hurlbut, Paul Broughton, Doug Waite, Darren Turcotte, Adam Graves, Mark Hardy, Randy Gillen, Mike Richter, Phil Bork, Mike Gartner, and Brian Leach, who are the co-chairman of Ice Hockey in Harlem.
And Bruce Beck, one of the better auctioneers.
Oh, he is super.
When it comes to trying to raise money for benefits, Bruce Beck does a terrific job. I think we have Dvorsky talking to Roger Nielsen right now. It's regarding line changes, I believe. And, of course, the coach is trying to get matchups. Roger Nielsen tries to wait to see what Brian Sutter is going to do.
Sends out Gillen with Phil Bork on the left, Joe Koser on the right. Jay Wells and Sergei Zubov on the fence.
Well, what happened was Kimball got involved running. They took him off. Hughes is on the ice now, so Koser's opposite Hughes.
Donato intercepted. The puck taken by Steve Hines. He's tied up by Koser. Gillen fires in. What do you make of this, John? Here's Zubov, the right-handed shot. Wells, the left-handed shot. Wells is playing the right side on defense and Zubov the left. Tough to figure.
Well, I mean, I guess Zubov just wants to play left defense, even though it's a right-handed shot. Many Europeans do that, way more than what we have here in North America.
Moog fires out for Steve Hines.
Basically, what you're seeing is it's more comfortable for Zubov, who has less experience, so why not do it that way? Wells can adjust.
Steve Hines, backhander went wide, played along the boards and centered by Brent Hughes all the way through. Wells checked by Hines, able to move it out of the zone. Glenn Wesley has it back. Just under 7 minutes to go in the first. Rangers leading 1-0. Goal by Tony Amonte at 4:17.
Wide open play for a number of minutes. Now things have settled right down.
Steal by Adam Oates. He moves in. 3-on-2. Chance for Juno and a good hit by Wells on Juno. Juno still looking for the puck.
It was Wells who made the bad pass, but he recovered and helped himself out with a hit on Juno.
Bartalnov with it, circling. Back pass to the point. Dave Shaw with a shot. Deflected in front. Caroms across to the boards where it's played by Nemchinov. Gartner trying to tip it ahead for Phil Bork. It's broken up the line by Don Sweeney. Back the other way comes Adam Oates. 3-on-2 across the line. Oates looking. Fork Bartalov blocked by Bukaboom. Cleared by Lowe. Rangers move down. Nemchinov with Gartner is poked out of the zone. Don Sweeney goes for the puck. Tied up by Erickson. Sweeney goes flying into the boards.
John Erickson is unbelievable. He hasn't played 19 games, and he's probably got more quickness out there maybe than anybody right now.
John, he's been really chomping at the bit.
Oh, man.
For the last week to 10 days.
And John, he wants to have body contact, everything.
Gordon Murphy shot wide. Kevin Lowe staying with Bartalov. The shot is a save by Van Beesbrouck. Van Beesbrouck clears the puck. up the boards, kept in by Gord Murphy. Pressure by the Bruins. Barkalov trying to get it to Oates. Barkalov moving against Erickson. This is Juneau moving with the puck. Now Oates. Oates picked up by Kevin Lowe. The pass for Gord Murphy gets a shot that's stopped by Van Beesbrouck, and Nemchinov has it.
Terrific line, and they cycle well in the corners, but the Rangers didn't fold. Their defensive assignments were good.
Nemchinov going all the way. He's taken out by Featherstone, and Murphy moves it out. Barkalov moves down. He's had goals in his last two games. Barkalov across, knocked down by Gartner. Messier checked there by Andrew Kim. McKim, I should say. Played across. Turcotte tried to tap it to Messier. Back comes McKim. He shoots. Saved by Van Beesbrouck. Moved by Hurlbut. Stopped by Wesley with 4:45 to go in the first. Wesley has it again. For McKim. Pass in front. Missed by Pantaleov. Steve Leach gets to the puck. James Patrick gets to him. The puck is loose. Nobody sees it. Then Patrick finds it. Leach all over him. Patrick able to move it out of the zone. Ray Bourque.
Boston pinning the Rangers, but the Rangers not giving up shots. They look so much more poised defensively, just not giving up any clean shots right now, yet Boston is really pressured.
Good pressure by Turcotte on Ray Bourque. Bruins try to come out, knocked away by Zubov. Pantaleov pushes it back into the Boston zone. 4 minutes to go in the first period. 1-0, Rangers leading. Glenn Wesley has it knocked away by Kovalov. Waite takes it away from Bourque and plays it to Zubov. Back across for Kovalov. Wesley cleared. Wells is hit by Dave Reed. They both go down. Kovalov trying to control. Gets it to Zubov. Rangers without a shot on goal in the last 10 minutes. You saw that. Wow, Rangers only 4 shots on goal thus far in the first period. They're being outshot. And it's 9-4.
Sam, it's not because they missed the net or anything. They just haven't had any opportunities yet. They've been taking care of the defensive zone better.
Kovalov on the move, trying to get away from Poulin. Kovalov heading for the net, knocked down. Zubov pinching in, able to get it to Doug Waite. Waite looking. Kovalov gets up and he bangs with Don Sweeney as he tries to get in front. He's pushed behind the net. Waite in the corner. Waite moving on board. Zubov pinching in again. Poulin takes over. Fires around the boards, and Kovalov knocked down Poulin.
He exploded on impact with Poulin.
Zubov avoids the hit. Attempt by Poulin, then he got whacked by Darren Kimball. Shot by Waite, blocked by Don Sweeney. Bruins fire down. Zubov knocks it down in center. 2:45 to go in the first. Rangers with a 1-0 lead on the goal by Tony Amonte. Waite drops it in the Boston zone. Len Featherstone back for it, and Koser hits him. Ray Bourque moves the puck out for Steve Hines. Across the line, Brent Hughes drops it off for Hines. Hines with a shot, and he scores! Steve Hines with a low rocket, beating Van Beesbrouck to the glove side.
All the way up ice, Boston avoided or took body checks. It started with Featherstone beside Moog with a hit by Koser. Then all the way up ice, Boston found a way to get a shot on goal. It says, after the hit on Featherstone, Bourque avoids a check. Now watch here, a check avoided. Now watch here, another check that's going to be taken, but the play's made. Now Hines can take the shot. He was going backwards towards the sideboards, and I think that's what fooled Van Beesbrouck. And the low shot, see how Hines was going backwards? Van Beesbrouck moved with him and left a little on the long side low. It was a very accurate shot. And we're tied at 1.
Steve Hines, one of those fine rookies that you mentioned that the Bruins have in the lineup. Here come the Bruins again. Hughes shot, he scores! And the Bruins with 2 quickies have grabbed the lead. Brent Hughes, this one went high on Van Beesbrouck.
You know, Hughes certainly not noted as a scorer by any means. Gets his second goal in 24 games on the season. But somehow Van Beesbrouck was handcuffed on the play. Didn't seem to adjust. Here, watch the Rangers. Can't get out of the zone. Messing with a puck at the blue line. Trouble. That was Mike Hurlbut. And Hughes, he just snapped it. It must have been through or beside James Patrick. And that surprised the goaltender, Van Beesbrouck. The puck goes by Patrick, over the shoulder, an accurate hard shot. But Hurlbut messed around with the puck at the blue line. That spells trouble. And the Rangers are now down by 1. with just 2 minutes, 10 seconds left in the first period.
Brent Hughes had a career total of 5 goals coming into the season. So you're right when you say he's not a goal scorer. 2 minutes remaining in the first. Hughes really snapped that one.
Yes, he did. Those were two pretty good shots.
Bruins, 2 goals in 9 seconds. And it's a 2-1 Boston lead. And the Rangers are still stuck on only 4 shots on goal.
It's going to be interesting to see what happens now with the Rangers' psyche after playing fairly strong defensively, not getting offense, but playing strong defensively. Then all of a sudden, boom, boom, and they're down and trailing.
Minute and a half remaining in the first period. 2-1 Boston. Hines with his 10th from Hughes and Bork at 17:36. Hughes with his 2nd from Sweeney and Donato at 17:45. 9 seconds apart. Turcotte to Patrick. Patrick and Hurlbut on with Messier, Gartner, and Turcotte. Gartner goes off. And whistle for an offside. On the play, 1:12 remaining in the first. We'll step out for a moment. Back to the action. Dmitry Kartanov with a shot off the pass from Adam Oates. Van Biesbrouck making the save. 45 seconds to go, first period. Kartanov firing it out. Amonti has it back. 40 seconds to go. Bruins out shooting the Rangers 12-4, leading 2-1. Here's Bartolov winding up for another long shot. Van Biesbrouck knocks it into the corner, and Jay Wells takes over. Now Sergei Zubov. Zubov winds up. That one is high. Bangs down off the glass. Bogue pushes it to Bork. 20 seconds to go on the period. Out of the zone it goes. Races on. Pantaleov against Zubov. Gets it to Steve Leach. Lost control. Zubov. Moves it to Amonti. Amonti with Messier. Amonti winds up and drives it. It trickles on goal. Moog stopping it. The Rangers are credited with a shot on goal. And the end of the first period. Looked good for a while. Van Biesbrouck was making the saves. The defensive play overall was good. The penalty killing, excellent. The Rangers had the 1 goal by Tony Amonti, and then suddenly at 17:36, it all changed on a goal by Steve Hines, followed 9 seconds later on a goal by Brent Hughes. 2-1, Boston leading the Rangers, end of 1. Al Trotwig's coming up. Don't go away.
Second period at the Garden, where the Bruins lead the Rangers by the score of 2-1. This is the visitors' bench at Madison Square Garden. In the winter of 1979, it was occupied by the Boston Bruins. It was then that the glass was a lot lower. We're going to take you back on our Coke Classic play to a very dim night as far as hockey players getting involved with fans are concerned. And maybe in a moment we'll get an idea exactly who was to blame. John Davidson, Sam Rosen, can you possibly get to the bottom of this? John, I've heard that you were the guy who started this mess.
Well, I'm not very proud of it, Al, to tell you the truth. It was a night in which the Rangers lost. The goaltender, Jerry Cheevers, made a great save at the end of the game. I was skating off. I had personally had lost 4 straight games, and I watched Al Secord level Ulf Nilsson at the end of the game, and I exploded, went after Secord. And what happened was both teams got in front of the Boston bench. The players then moved over to the side where the boards are, and a fan got involved with Stan Jonathan, and with the very low glass, all the fans were involved. All the Bruins got involved with the fans. You see the Ranger players watching. I actually went into the locker room after this and sat there. I was absolutely in shock being a part of this whole thing, and there was people that lost their jobs, including the referee. An emotional night that was ugly and dim.
Well, it kept the lawyers busy for years. Thankfully, the glass is higher. I think you'd have to be literally Carl Lewis to get over the glass now.
Thankfully.
John, shame on you.
Good point. I admit it. Al, I absolutely admit it. It was something that where emotions took over, but in retrospect, never should have happened.
I was up in the press box that night, John, and I still can't believe it. To see that again.
Imagine, Peter McNabb was up there.
That's right.
I talked to Peter McNabb about it, the fine broadcaster with the Devils. He says, I can't believe when I look back, even thinking that I did that.
Set to start the second period. Bruins with a 2-1 lead. Bruins have won 3 in a row after losing 3 in a row. They're 8-4 in their last 12. And the overhead shot coming to you from the upper deck trading card cam. Waite, Kovalov, and Graves. Patrick and Hurlbut start for the Rangers. The puck sliding down, and Moog stops it for Glenn Wesley.
Just trying to remember if my buddy Don Cherry was coaching that team.
sure. I can't remember.
I'll try and look it up. We have a whistle and a penalty as Kovalov was taken down. Paul Dvorsky will make the call. As Gordon Murphy goes off and the Rangers will get a power play. Take a look at the first period scoring summary brought to you by Amtrak's Metroliner service. 16 departures to downtown D.C. every business day. Tony Amonte at 4:17 gave the Rangers the lead, and then the two goals 9 seconds apart. Hines with his 10th. Brent Hughes with his second. Shots on goal. Boston 14. Bartolnov leading with 3. Rangers 5. Only 2 Rangers had shots on goal. Amonte had 3 and Gartner had 2. Gord Murphy is called for holding at 17 seconds. Rangers get their second power play.
Kovalov makes a little move, and you can see how he was pulled down with one arm on the stick. Rangers have a nice chance here to try and get the power play going and tie the thing up.
Bruins penalty killing is 16th in the league. They've given up 39 power play goals this season.
Now remember Boston's penalty killing. They don't attack the puck carrying the neutral zone. Ooh, there's a pass. If that works, it's breakaway Mike Gartner. But you see there, the Bruins backing all the way up, and the Rangers able to try and make the pass to Gartner, who cuts across the blue line, or just move into the zone and try and get set up. They'll be attacked as they try to enter the Boston zone. Now watch Turcotte move up. He'll see Gartner move from left to right. There, see that? Oh, baby, if that pass clicks, about 2 feet wide, Gartner's in on the breakaway.
That's Gartner's favorite move, to go along the blue line and get that long pass. Rangers with Turcotte and Hurlbut. Gartner, Wait, and Amonte for the power play. Poulin with Reed, Wesley, and Bork to try and kill it off. Shot in by Turcotte.
Boston Bruins have McVee Sutter work habits, don't they?
Oh, man.
They're like piranha on the ice.
What a changeover this team has made.
Yeah.
And they're playing so well.
The game changed, and credit Harry Sinden and Mike Milbury with changing and having focus and vision. As the game changed, they changed partly ahead of it.
Mm-hmm.
And you can see they're not nearly as big, nor as the, they're not the brawling, big, bad Bruins, but they're fast, very skilled, and highly entertaining, to tell you the truth.
Wait. On the move, drops it down the boards. Featherstone goes over, rides Wade into the boards. Amonte's got the puck. Now Hurlbut across to Turcotte. Looking, set up down low is Gartner. Now Hurlbut's got it. Can't get a shot off. Reed picks him up. Puck moved to Amonte, and he's hit by Featherstone. Featherstone blocked the pass. Rangers have to regroup in center ice. And the puck given away and cleared by Featherstone. And not a shot on goal by the Rangers on this power play, which has only 25 seconds remaining. Sergei Zubov has come on with Nemchinov, Turcotte, Graves. John, I'm looking for the fifth Ranger.
Just stepped on the ice now.
Wow, Kovalov just stepped off. Rangers went about 10 seconds with only 4 players on the ice.
I was trying to count it too.
Turcotte's backhand is saved by Mogan. He's got it.
Yes, quite a number of seconds, and finally Kovalov jumped over the boards as the Rangers wasted part of their own power play, and now the teams are back at even strength.
Things not going well, and you can see Roger Nielsen's got to be a little concerned right now. I thought maybe there was a Ranger hiding somewhere.
We see 3 Rangers there and 3 Bruins, so you have a 3-on-3 situation.
I know the Rangers like a 4-on-4, John, but when you have the power play, you got to take it, guys. Kovalov was the man coming on late on the change. Teams are back at full strength. Rangers now 0-for-2 on the power play. Did not get, you know, got the one shot on goal.
I don't think I see Mark Messier on the bench. I didn't see him on the power play. And there's only 13 Rangers on the bench from what I see. I think Messier is in the dressing room. He's having problems with a flu. And I don't think he's returned here for the second period.
And Mr. Trotwig is on the case. Bartolnov moves in. He's forced back by Bukaboom. 2-1, Bruins leading it. 2:40 gone by in the second. Bukaboom had the hit along the boards. Koser and Gillen move down with the puck, along with Eriksson. Moog plays it off the glass.
Now when you try and play with the flu, and people, I don't think, in watching the game understand how much a hockey player perspires, and you can be dehydrated quickly, especially when you have the flu. I'm sure that Kevin Lowe has been told drink a lot of fluids. It looks like Mark Messier tried, played in the first period, and it looks as though he just either ran out of steam or the flu just got to him. Kevin Lowe and Messier are roommates when they travel and are on the road. The Rangers team had flu shots as a team. It was an optional type thing to try and avoid the flu. Boston's getting over the flu primarily. The Rangers having it hit their team and their families as well. And it's affected him. Mark Messier is not here for the second period.
I know Chris King was bothered by it yesterday when he played.
Stephen King has it bad, I understand, today. One of the reasons he's not in the lineup.
Nemchinov to Kevin Lowe moving in. Rick shot, knocked away with a blocker by Andy Moog. Kevin Lowe and Andy Moog were teammates in Edmonton. The puck cleared out. A little over 3 minutes gone by in the second. Van Beesbrouck stops the puck. Bukaboom picks it up. Bukaboom with Lowe. Nemchinov, Gartner, and Turcotte make that Gartner and Erickson on the ice. And we have a whistle for a two-line pass. Whistle against the Rangers. They'll bring it back. Sergei Nemchinov, over the last couple of weeks, has been the Rangers' best player. He has really lifted his game. Championship boxing, the world heavyweight title, coming to Madison Square Garden February the 6th. When Riddick Bowe makes his first title defense, it'll be against one-time heavyweight champ Michael Dynamite Dukes. And as usual, there'll be a great undercard. Tickets on sale January 5th at Garden Box Office and Ticketmaster 212-307-7171. Al Trotwig has an update downstairs. Al, what's happening?
Yes, Sam, Dr. John was correct. Mark is suffering from the flu. He's evidently, from what trainer Dave tells me, very sick in the Rangers locker room. But I think we may have seen the last of him. Back to you.
Thanks, Al. You were right.
Well, Mark tried, gave the period a period of play for the Rangers. And the flu knocks you down, the legs get heavy, you get dehydrated. It's very difficult to get anything accomplished.
Icing whistled against the Rangers this time. And play stops with 16:18 remaining in the second period, 2-1 Boston. We have a break in the action, and during this break, Midas reminds you, for breaks done right, nobody beats Midas. Nobody. Good record for the Bruins against Patrick Division teams. Well, they've had a pretty good record against most teams. The Bruins with sitting in second place with 44 points. Long shot from the point by Gord Murphy went wide. Darren Turcotte is now centering for Tony Amonte and Adam Graves. As Roger Nielsen mixes things up, Turcotte was taken down in center ice. Play continuing, and the Bruins have it. Gord Murphy with a puck, able to move it to Andrew McKim. McKim across with Steve Hines, and Gregory Pantaleoff with a shot, and Van Beesbrouck stays with it and makes the save. What a move and a redirection by Pantaleoff.
Boy, you see the Bruins showing some of that speed we talked about. McKim, look at his head up, looking across the ice, waiting to make the play, and finally elevates the puck across. Pantaleoff drives to the net. We talked about that in the first period. He's a powerful skater, and you see the play. McKim scored the goal last night in Hartford, his first goal. His parents, who live up in the eastern part of Canada, out in the islands, called Mike Milbury and said, "Is it true you're calling my son up?" And he sort of, well, finally said, "Yeah, I'm going to call him up." So they drove to Hartford. The kid scored his first NHL goal. The parents were in tears in the stands. And what a celebration it was for the family. The kid is a small kid, but he scored everywhere he's been, finally getting a chance down in the National Hockey League. And I understand, I didn't see the goal, but he undressed Steve Conwright, I understand.
Oh, yes, absolutely.
Beautiful play.
Tremendous goal. Inside, outside, split the defense, and a great shot over Pietrangelo.
He was a Calgary Flames property at one time. But then I think an Edmonton property, and now he's a Boston property at no charge.
Gartner moving in, quick shot stick to side by Moog. Bruins leading 2-1. The one Bruin missing, I know you've been looking for a missing Bruin, John, it's Don Sweeney. He's having his skate repaired and will be back momentarily. Knocked away by Van Beesbrouck from Kvartalnov. Bukaboom brings it out with Nemchinov. And Bukaboom lifts it in. Featherstone hit by Nemchinov. Nemchinov goes down. It tells you how strong Featherstone is. And Chinoff's a strong man, and he got the worst of that collision. Bork brings it in. Lost it. Doug Waite carries in. Waite moves in against Bork. Drops it off. Turning is Kevin Lowe. Lowe still with it in deep. He's tied up along the boards. Bruins work it loose, but it's given away to Waite. Moog moves it to Bork. He gave it away to Kovalov. Stick handles in. It's poke checked away from him. He turns and fires wide. Graves gets to the puck. Waite for Kovalov, and he's tied up as he crashes to the net. And the Bruins drive it all the way down. Went off a Rangers stick. Rangers have to go back to get it. Sergei Zubov picks it up. 2-1 Boston. 14:05 to go in the second. Two goals in 9 seconds for the Bruins by Steve Hines and Brent Hughes. Giving the Bruins the lead after Tony Amonte had scored early for the Rangers. Kovalov went down, and icing is whistled against the Rangers. Fans roared. Every time Kovalov does anything, the fans roar.
I asked him tonight prior to the game how his leg was, and he goes, he got slashed by, I think it was Dalgarno, was it not?
Yes, it was.
On the island last night, no penalty on the play. He did have a welt on the back of his leg. There he was hooked down by Hughes. And Paul Dvorsky, who's one of the better young referees in the league, decides to let that one slide right on by.
13:50 remaining in the second as Alexei Kovalov goes off. Rangers changing. Take a look at what happened yesterday. Take you back to the Nassau Coliseum. I don't know if you want to go back if you're a Ranger fan, but here's what happened.
Over on the right side, there's Dalgarno with a slash going down with a stick to the back of the calf. Left calf of Kovalov. I'm sorry, Sam.
See, Dan Maloney, Ranger coaching staff, was very upset that Paul Stewart did not make a call on the play. Puck kept in by David Shaw. His pass across broken up by Zubov. Koser's got it.
Call or no call, the Islanders played a very good game.
Oh, yes,
last
they
night.
Did. Brent Hughes into the Rangers zone. Van Beesbrouck reaches out. Wells has the puck. He's hit by Steve Hines, but able to move it. Gillen for Koser, a little behind him. Wells stops the puck, and now Zubov is on the right side, and he moves it out. Randy Gillen carrying. Broken up by Wesley. Bruins playing a solid defensive game here. Puck bounces off the boards into the crowd. 13:06 remaining in the second, and the Rangers trailing 2-1. The crowd beginning to get a little restless here.
And more World Junior action today, Sam.
What happened?
Canada beat the Swedes. Sweden's favorite as the tournament is in Sweden. And what a player Forsberg is for Sweden. He'll belong to Quebec next year as one of the players that went from Philadelphia to Quebec. And I think he's going to be in Quebec for next season. And is he ever good? Finland beat Japan 7-0. Russia beat Germany 4-0. And a very disappointing game. Czechoslovakia beat Team USA 6-5. So Team USA starts the tournament 0-2.
Canada 2-0. Good start for the Canadians.
But that's a real disappointment, I think, for Team USA. They're a pretty good squad. 6 first-rounders on the team.
Puck out in center ice. Steve Leach trying to get there, but James Patrick broke it up. Now Ray Bork takes over. He's knocked down by Tony Amonte. Pantaleov left the puck behind him, and Patrick's got it. Moves it ahead. Tony Amonte moving in. Amonte looking. Holds up. Pass for Patrick. Save. Rebound.
Oh,
and a great save by Andy Moog to Rob Patrick.
It looked like 2-2, and all of a sudden the catching hand, the strength of Andy Moog's game, flashed out and caught the puck.
Must be a good book, John.
It's Fred Shiro's book. Boston has so far allowed the Rangers only 10 shots on goal. And we're over the midpoint of the game. And my reasoning is, I think, is that Boston's had the puck the majority of the game. And no wonder the Rangers haven't been able to get much as far as shots on goal.
At the layoff with McKim and Steve Leach for Boston. Kovalov with a puck. Fires out and gave it away. McKim with a shot blocked by Kovalov. Trying to break out. Pushes it. And Murphy is able to stop. Bruins send it back in. Jay Wells has it. 8:45 to go. Second period. Bruins leading 2-1. Here's Kovalov looking to break down. Featherstone gets back. Graves heading for the net. The pass is blocked. Knocked down by Murphy. Stopped by Kovalov. He avoids Steve Leach. He moves in looking for an opening. Kovalov still with a puck. Steve Leach on him. Puck in the corner. Moves around behind the net to Kovalov. Trying to get out in front. Saved by Moog. And it's covered up. Good effort. Now Waite and Graves in front doing some pushing and shoving.
A little intensity here. Kovalov with some magic trying to find open people. But credit to Bruins. there wasn't many white jerseys left open, even though Kovalov did his best to avoid checks, to slide away from people, to try and make something happen offensively. And the Bruins just simply got the job done in their own zone. Kovalov avoided a number of checks. Watch this one where he darts low. Boom. Gets around the check. Now he goes back. Look at the white jerseys in front. They're all covered. Graves was open for just a second. Kovalov will avoid more people. Now watch in front when Kovalov gets the puck back here. Anybody open? Adam Graves is checked. And Kovalov pays. Boston very sharp in their own zone.
Now what we're seeing is Kovalov, who never had a reputation for being so strong, he's really, really showing some good strength.
Put on 15 pounds from last season. He's still a young man.
Patrick shot knocked down in front. It's loose. Turcotte trying to move it. It's stopped by Brent Hughes. He lifts it clear. Turcotte got a stick on it, batted it up into the air, bounces down. Steve Hines moves in. He shoots. Tipped by Patrick and up into the crowd it goes.
These little things. You see how hard Donato, number 21, worked at staying onside, allowing Hines to get in and maybe get a shot on goal. Boston have many, many meetings regarding intensity. Brian Sutter may not win all the games, but they won't be outworked very often. We're seeing another example of it here.
Kerblut falls down. Brent Hughes takes the puck away. Center is missed by Hines. Amati couldn't take it out. Donato bumps with James Patrick. Steve Hines trying to come off the boards with it. Taken away from Turcotte. Shot by Donato. Saved by Van Beesbrouck. Moved up the boards and out of the zone. Rangers will take an icing here. Dave Shaw comes back, touches up, and play stops. 7:39 to go. Second period. Bruins 2, Rangers 1. Tommy McVie, the assistant coach of the Boston Bruins, and as always, he has some Christmas wishes for us, John.
Yeah, I wish they'd get off my back, you know. And another thing with those guys, you know, like when I got fired, like I never heard from them for about 8 years, and now when I was coaching the Devils, they wanted to talk to me every day. And then I get fired, now I didn't hear from them again, so they can all take a flying leap.
Tom, he didn't say that to me today on the phone.
Oh, yeah, what did he say?
Oh, man, I said, what'd you do for Christmas? He said, I stayed at the rink. I said, why'd you do that? He said, well, the last time I left the rink for Christmas, I came back and someone else was in my chair.
Said he doesn't talk to his wife during hockey season. I think he better invoice Madison Square Garden Network. He's been on enough, hasn't he?
Nemchinov with the puck, 7:15 to go. Gartner down the boards with a quick shot glove by Moog. Rangers with only 12 shots on goal, and that last one is a gimme because that was going wide of the net.
Quality chances kept by our statistician, Scott Cooper. Boston 13, Rangers 6. And that's close to being accurate, I think, Sam.
Moog moves it around the boards for Gord Murphy. Out in center ice, Rangers changing. Erickson gets to the puck. 2-1 Boston, 6:45 to go in the second. Murphy playing the puck out. Picked up by Junot. Lead for Adam Oates. Looking for Junot down the middle. He moves in. He shoots. Saved by Van Beesbrouck, and he covers up. In the circle, Dave Reed is spun around. The puck kicked away. Played by Sergei Zubov. Zubov slides it across to Phil Bork. Bork with Koser and Giller.
Nemchinov is having problems on the Rangers bench with his right arm and shoulder. He's being attended to as play moves on.
Giller around the net. Checked by Poulin. Darren Kimball takes it. Out for Dave Reed. Bangs off the end boards and Van Beesbrouck fires it off. The boards kept in. Poulin's got the puck. Behind the net, Kimball. He's checked by Wells. Reed plays it off the side of the net. Zubov takes it away from Kimball. Koser tipping it to Gillen. Gillen moving down. Bork ahead of him. Nice pass. Bork pulled down. And a penalty upcoming on the Boston Bruins.
There was a little tip pass back in the Rangers zone by Joey Koser, allowing the Rangers to move out. Bork had speed, and because of his speed, he drew the penalty. I think he helped us along, too, on Poulin. But Bork was smart. Now watch Koser right here. Touch the puck, just give it to Gillen. That allows the Rangers to spring out of the zone. There's the pass. Now watch Bork get hooked.
and he helps it along. It's a smart play. Rangers get themselves a power play, and they need one right now to try and get some offensive momentum going. Even if they don't score in a power play, it's the idea of trying to get some flow going offensively. They've been held to 12 shots on goal. Nemchinov is flexing his right arm. Let's see what happens here. He moves in on Featherstone. It's a loose puck. Nemchinov goes for it. Featherstone goes for it. Boom. And it's not the hit. It's this here. Oh, yeah. The collision into the wall. So not only the collision on the shoulder, but the crash into the boards. And Sergei's hurting up top around the shoulder and neck.
Rangers power play their third. They are 0 for 2. They are 1 for their last 30. They got the one last night at the Nassau Coliseum when Amonte scored. Wait, Gartner and Amonte with Hurlbutt and Turcotte for the power play. Shaw couldn't clear it. Donato, Sweeney, Hines, and Shaw for the Bruins. Battle along the boards. Amonte looking for the puck. So is Doug Waite. It's out to Turcotte. Amonte. Pressured by Don Sweeney. The puck moved ahead by Turcotte to Waite in the corner. He's checked by Shaw. Gartner comes up with it. Back pass to Turcotte. Across to Hurlbutt. Takes the shot. It's deflected wide and bounces off the glass. Amonte trying to get it back to Turcotte, but it's cleared out by Steve Hines. And that unit of four goes off for Boston, and a fresh unit comes on. Mark Bork and Wesley with Reed and Oates.
Mark Messier out with a flu for the second period. It affects penalty killing, face-offs, power play, ice time in general. And when you don't have Leach or Messier, the problems mount.
Turcotte takes the puck from Van Beesbrouck, but gave it up to Wesley and center ice back into the Rangers zone. 4.5 minutes to go in the second. Bruins 2, Rangers 1. Fans getting on the Rangers, who are struggling here on the power play. 35 seconds remaining in the man advantage. Hurlbutt sending it in, was taken down. Hold leaves it for Bork, who pushes it to Wesley. Wesley with room, able to clear. Dave Reed going for the puck. Hurlbutt after him, pokes at it. Adam Oates takes over. His pass comes in front to Reed. He scores!
Shorthanded. That's 7 for the Bruins on the season. You know, Reed's not a quick skater, but he's a smart checker and a smart penalty killer. He got in behind everybody, and somehow the puck sprung loose to him. And then he went in and showed some poise, beating Van Beesbrouck 3-1 Boston. See Reed break in here, and it looks like there's not a problem. Now, he'll stay behind everyone, and the puck comes right back to him from Adam Oates. That's how it got there. And Reed scores 3-1 Boston. Adam Oates ends up making the play. I couldn't see who it was. Watch Reed. Oates is surrounded. Went off a skate blade. That's how it got there. Reed went wide, took his time to make sure Van Beesbrouck was down. That's a big goal for Boston, a shorthanded one. Gives them 7 on the season.
Reed was a penalty killing specialist up in Toronto. A couple of years ago was outstanding with the shorthanded goal scored. That is the 8th shorthanded goal given up by the Rangers this season. Reed from Oates and Wesley at 15:56. Rangers power play is over. They're 0 for 3. The Bruins score shorthanded. It's 3-1. Patrick with Gillen and Bork. The shot is saved. The rebound wide. Patrick for Gillen. It comes through to Koser. Koser back pass. Zuboff fakes. Now he shoots. Knocked down in front, and Don Sweeney's got the puck. Fires it down the ice. It deflects into the Bruins bench. And play stops. 3:27 to go. A little pushing and shoving.
No, Bork's surrounded. Some of his teammates. Now Randy Gillen gets over there.
A look at our quote book. James Patrick on the Rangers power play without Brian Leach. We still have guys who can play the power play. It seems the more we struggle, the more frustrated we get, nervous and panicky. All those factors make us try to make a play that isn't there instead of being a little more patient. Rangers now 0 for 3 in the game, 1 for the last 31. Kovalov scores! Alexei Kovalov wakes up the crowd in the Rangers bench as he goes around the net to get his 9th goal of the season. It's a 3-2 game.
Faceoff inside the Boston zone. When Kovalov goes around the net, Moats thinking a stuff type play, a wraparound type play. Good hustle off the draw as Waite controlled it. Now watch the goaltender go down. There. Kovalov now sees it Top shelf. Andy Moog was already down, was not square. Rangers are back in it. Kovalov has played hard.
Graves heading for the net. Backhander is a save by Moog.
That was because of forechecking by Kovalov. Kovalov has played a hard game for the Rangers.
Knocked down by Waite. Keep it in the zone.
I say hard, that's a compliment.
Along the boards, pitching in is James Patrick. Fires it around the net. And it slides out of the zone. Since his recall from Binghamton, this is Alexei Kovalov's 11th game. And he has scored 6 goals. That is his 9th of the season. Waite gets the assist at 16:41, and it comes 45 seconds after the Bruins have taken the 2-goal lead. Here's Wesley moving to the net, and a save by Van Beesbrouck. Waite picks up the puck, slides it out to Kovalov. He's one-on-one with Ray Bourque. The crowd rises to its feet. Kovalov stops.
He's at the end of a shift.
Spinorama holds on, plays it toward the net, but all the way through. Kevin Lowe takes over. 2:10 to go. Kovalov still there. Kovalov against Bourque. Slid through Erickson on goal. Moog stops it, covers up, and the crowd cheers Alexei Kovalov.
You know, I think Kovalov, in scoring the goal, he stayed on the ice. It was a long shift. I believe it was Kovalov who missed his man in his own zone, which allowed the defenseman Wesley to move in. This is the goal early in the shift, off the draw. Waite helped win the draw. You see in front the pick by Graves, the goaltender down, top corner. Rangers back in it. Same shift though. Adam Graves with a nice job in front, allowing the open ice to be used by Kovalov. Same shift. Kovalov turned in his own zone, forgot about the defenseman, and Wesley moved in and nearly scored. So a little bit of everything from Kovalov. He's exciting, and he has played a hard game, an intense game. He's taken the body, and he's made things happen.
Kovalov with his 9th from Waite at 16:41. Reed had scored his 6th from Oates and Wesley at 15:56. It's 3-2 Boston as Dave Poulin goes in. There's a penalty coming up on the Rangers.
It'll be on Erickson for interference. Back, as Erickson was back-checking, one of the Bruins got knocked down. Very seldom do you see Jan Erickson take a penalty, only his 3rd minor of the season, and this is 13th game.
Al Troutwig standing by downstairs. What's happening, Al?
Sam, I'm with my buddy Joe, the equipment man, who's going to reenact what it's like when Alexei Kovalov goes past. Joe? It's been unbelievable. He's really been fast. But we've been watching the play of Adam Oates, and you guys have been talking about him a lot and what he's doing for the young mates of his line. He did for Brett Hull last year. We're going to talk to him, get his feelings about what it's like to see Brett struggling as much as he is at the end of period two. Back to you.
Thanks, Al.
No, Brett Hull's been shopped around a little bit, very quietly by the Blues. Very quietly. Imagine if he got into one of those uniforms with that guy right there.
Whoa.
I'm not saying it. No, you're not starting a rumor, are you? I'm just saying quietly the Blues have checked around to see if there's interest in Brett Hull. There's nothing happening anywhere that I know of, except for they're not talking about completing that big contract that Hull's involved with in St. Louis. I know that.
Bruins power play, their 4th. They're 0-for-3. They had a 5-on-3 early in the game. Beesbrouck made the save. A shot blocked in front. Wesley's got the puck in the shot. Knocked down in front again. Oates comes loose with a puck. Oates with Bartolnoff and Juno. Bourque with a shot blocked by Lowe and cleared by Gillen. Gillen with Graves, Lowe, and Bukaboom. Erickson went for interference at 18:07. Kevin Lowe takes over, bangs it off the glass. Bourque stops it with a left glove, fires it across to Wesley off his skate. Juno takes over, looks. Steve Hines is set up in front. Down for Oates, and he scores. Adam Oates.
Oh, what a play.
That's his 5th consecutive power play goal. His last 5 goals have been on the power play and 10 of his last 14.
You know, Oates is a magnificent passer, but to watch Juno, Joey Juno, make this play, he waited, showed patience. Juno's on the puck now. Fake shot. He's drawn 2 players out, and you see the beautiful pass. Oh! And it was a rocket-type pass, much like a Montes last night to Messier when Messier finished. Oates has to collect the pass. Look at that thing. And then hit the open side. That pass was elevated by Joey Juno over 2 stick blades and landed flat so Oates could take the pass and finish it with the shot. it just doesn't get any better. What a wonderful play that was.
This is Adam Oates' eighth year in the league. He played four years with Detroit, almost three seasons with St. Louis. Was traded last season to Boston. His career high in the season is 25 goals. He now has 21 in
35 games.
35 games. Roger Nielsen upset.
Upset with the call on Erickson, I believe. Erickson was back-checking, and that's why the penalty happened. And I think in a 3-2 game, I think Roger Nielsen is probably terming it a cheap call. And Jan Erickson, very seldom, with all the hitting we've seen in this game, for a call like that to be made, Roger might have a strong point.
Oates with his 21st, his 13th power play goal from Juneau and Wesley at 18:55. And it's 4-2 Boston. 40 seconds remaining in the second period. Moog bangs it around the boards. Hines with a bump along the boards on Sergei Zubov. It's cleared out. 30 seconds to go. And once again, the Rangers have given up four goals in a game. They've been unable to hold teams down. Looked for a while as if they were playing sharp defensively. They gave up two goals late in the first period and two goals late here in the second. In fact, in the final 4 minutes and 4 seconds of this second period, three goals have been scored between the two teams. Brent Hughes moving in, Zubov takes it, and that's it. Second period comes to an end. Boston won the first period 2-1. They win the second period 2-1. And at the end of two, the fans unhappy with the Rangers play. Andy Moog has done a fine job in stopping 16 of 18 shots. He's gotten good help from his teammates who have bottled up the Rangers. And at the end of two, the Rangers head for the locker room, trailing the Boston Bruins 4-2. Al Trotwig coming up with Adam Oates, who scored the Bruins' fourth goal. We'll be right back. The ice, the Bruins holding a two-goal lead. We'll look at the second period scoring summary brought to you by your Tri-State GMC truck dealers, the strength of experience. It was 2-1, end of one, and then late in the period, shorthanded goal by Dave Reed, his sixth from Oates and Wesley. 16:41, Kovalov answers back with his ninth. It was 3-2, but at 18:55, Adam Oates, power play goal from Juneau and Wesley, made it 4-2, shots on goal. Bruins another 14, they have 28. Rangers 13 as they picked it up, total of 18. Gartner has 5. Kovalov had 3 in the second period. Amonti, who had 3 in the first period, was shut out in the second period. Kartalnov leads Boston with 5 shots on goal. And Juneau had 3 in the second period. And Adam Oates, with a goal and an assist in the game, continues to add to his point totals. He now has 59 points, and this is 35th game. Take a look at the U.S. healthcare injury update. Brian Leetch still out with a stretched nerve in the neck and shoulder. Cam Neely remains out indefinitely after knee surgery. Vladimir Ruzicka is out indefinitely with a groin strain. The Bruins just got 3 players back from injury last night when Ray Bourque, Glenn Wesley, and Brent Hughes returned to the lineup.
Bourque was out with an upper back strain, and certainly getting Bourque back along with the others, good news for the Bruins.
There's that great camera, the Upper Deck Company, providing us the Upper Deck trading card cam angle above the ice.
I just can't figure out where the guy is that sits up there to run that thing.
That's a big scoreboard, you know, the Garden Vision board. Underway third period. Doug Waite with Alexei Kovalov and Adam Graves, Sergei Zubov and James Patrick for the Rangers. Andy Moog sends it around the boards. Kovalov stops it. Don Sweeney is on with David Shaw on defense. Ted Donato with Brent Hughes. And Steve Hines for Boston. Shaw moves it, took a hit from Kovalov. Patrick keeps it in. Wait behind the net. Was taken down. Penalty call on David Shaw. And the shot deflected off of Andy Moog.
And Kovalov within a hair of tying the game up. A good quick start for the Rangers. Randy Gillen, along with Doug Waite and Kovalov, with a strong shift, forcing David Shaw to take the penalty and not tie it up, pardon me, to make it a one-goal game. I've got it in here that it's a one-goal game. There you see the penalty. And watch Kovalov here. At the top side, couldn't hit it. Dvorsky with the arm up. So the Rangers now will have a chance to make it a one-goal game.
Got it now?
I think so.
Shaw for tripping. Rangers' fourth power play of the game. They are 0-3. And as I mentioned earlier, going back to the Montreal game when they missed on their last two chances, they are 1 for their last 31 on the power play. Cause for concern for Coach Roger Nielsen. Shaw for tripping at 35 seconds.
You know who's not here at the game tonight?
Mm-hmm.
Walter McPeak, one of the sports writers for the Rangers over in New Jersey.
From the Newark Star-Ledger.
That's it. 50 years of age.
Ooh.
Stayed home. The wife threw a party.
Very nice.
Happy birthday.
They're probably watching the game. Glove save by Andy Moog on the shot by Zuboff.
Tricky shot because Adam Graves was in front, and Zuboff appeared to be backing up, yet still got velocity, forcing Andy Moog into making a good save. Adam Graves will circle, stand right in front of Moog. Zuboff, before he was to be checked, was able to find a way to quickly release the shot. Watch Zuboff and how the Bruin came right to him quickly. Still, look at that.
Mm.
Accurate play, and Graves standing in front.
Wait, Graves and Kovalov up front with Zuboff and Patrick playing the points. Rangers without Mark Messier, who left the game after the first period with the flu. Puck all the way down. Van Beesbrouck leaves it for Sergei Zuboff. Poulin, Reed, Bork, and Wesley for Boston, and the Bruins have a shorthanded goal by Dave Reed. Long pass intended for Graves. Moog comes out to play it. Bork goes over. Pops high in the air, is batted down with a glove by Patrick, who took a glove in the face from Dave Reed.
Probably the most ice time that Kovalov has had as a New York Ranger. He has played a lot, and he has played well.
Kovalov has the puck go off his stick and is cleared down the ice by Ted Donato. 1 minute to go on the power play. Patrick wheels away from Steve Hines. Hines and Donato on with Don Sweeney and Glenn Featherstone. Turcotte moving in. Turcotte, who has not had a goal in seven consecutive games. This could be eight unless he can break out here in the third. Hurlbutt has the puck. Mike Hurlbutt with Kevin Lowe, Darren Turcotte, Tony Amonte, and Mike Gartner. Turcotte shooting wide. Amonte goes for the puck. Up the boards to Hurlbutt. Quickly across to Kevin Lowe. Moving in for the shot. Deflected wide. Around the boards. It's chopped out and cleared by Steve Hines. Lowe turns with 22 seconds to go on the power play. Moog has to go off his glove. Bork chops it up into the crowd, and play stops with 15 seconds to go on the power play. 2 minutes, 23 seconds gone by in the third. You look at the great Ray Bourque. Four-time Norris Trophy winner. He won the Calder Trophy his first year in the league as the outstanding rookie of the year. And four Norris Trophies as the top defenseman in the year. And when he hasn't won it, he's usually been in the top three.
And you notice this year, he's not leading the team in scoring. Nor is, how about this? Still leading the team with shots on goal, but with the great line with Oates, Juno, and Bartolnoff up front, you don't see Ray Bourque having to rush up and make things happen offensively nearly as much. He'll probably have more strength come playoff time because of it.
I agree. Patrick with a puck. 5 seconds to go on the power play. Zuboff.
Mark Messier played 79 games last year for the Rangers. Of course, he missed the opener. And he's played every game this year except for these two periods. And when you see Messier not in the lineup, it tells you that there's offense missing from the Rangers. And it tells you that it's a necessity to find a way to get offense. And however you do it as management, you've got to find a way to do it. This is an example of another centerman that's missed offensively on this team.
Around the boards, with a little over 3 minutes gone by, the team's at full strength. Rangers are 0 for 4 in the game. Bartolnoff moving in. Rangers on the power play continue to struggle. One for their last 32. Juno hustling after the puck, trying to take it away. Bartolnoff moves it around. Oates chasing. He's slowed down there. Rangers try to lift it clear, but can't do it. Bartolnoff back for it. Turcotte tried to line him up but missed the hit. Zuboff trying to find an opening. Oates just took it away. The pass in front comes all the way out. Zuboff had some trouble there, and Adam Oates just picked him clean. 16-15 to go in the third. 4-2, Boston leading it. Rangers put it in the Boston zone. Don Sweeney's got it. After tonight's game, the Rangers with three tough road games in a row. In Washington Tuesday night, at Buffalo Thursday night, at Pittsburgh Saturday night.
Got to go up against the Wild Thing in Washington. Am I Brady, who's been on fire.
Koser with good hustle negated what would have been an icing. Erickson working the boards. The backhander sticked aside by Moog. Good effort by Jan Erickson. Gord Murphy plays the puck for Boston. Deflected by Erickson. Bruins clear the zone. Kevin Lowe has it back.
Scotty Bowman did not coach the Penguins today in their win at Buffalo. Scotty's father, very sick. Scotty was up in Montreal, his dad in his 90s, and not doing well.
Erickson was taken down. The net comes off the pegs, and play stops with 15:27 to go on the third. Jan Erickson has had a good game in his first game back after missing 19 in a row. He's been very, very active.
Jan Erickson with just another hard-working shift for the Rangers. And Murphy made sure he took Erickson out of the play. The line on the ice now has been going pretty well for the Rangers. This is Graves, Kovalov, and Doug Waite.
Rangers get onside. Ray Bourque plays the puck for Boston. Bruins looking for their fourth win in a row. A steal by Graves and Moog with a big save.
See what Doug Waite did? He went right into Ray Bourque, forced his pass, and because of that, Graves was able to intercept the pass and take the shot. Andy Moog with a smart save. Watch Bourque. Tries to make the play, knowing Doug Waite was going to nail him. Actually, he went to the sideboards, which a defenseman should do, but Adam Graves was smart. He was right there. Boom, you see the turnover? The wrist shot, and Andy Moog just moved right on out, closed up everything, and took away the angle.
Rangers win the faceoff, but it slides out of the zone. Pantaleov was taken down on the play, was looking around for a call. Oates clears it out, Zuboff has it back. Bruins with the, here's Bourque trying to come down against Jay Wells. Circles back, looks around. Down low, Pantaleov, pass in front, blocked, intercepted by Zuboff. Kovalov has it with Graves through the neutral zone. Kovalov looking for a way in, gave it away. Pantaleov takes it back, plays it into the Rangers' zone, takes a hit. Rangers take over with 14:35 to go. Third period, Boston leading 4-2. Rangers got the first goal of the game, as they did last night. Now trail by two. Reed plays it into the Rangers zone. Boston with their fifth winning streak or unbeaten streak of the season. They started the season 3-0-1. Had a four-game winning streak late in October. Old reaches out, plays the puck. Now Patrick, broken up by Don Sweeney. Dave Poulin, they will get it to Dave Reed. Darren Kimball after the puck. Lowe gets there first. Able to work it clear. Boston had a three-game winning streak in mid-November. Gartner shot goes wide. Boston had another four-game winning streak the end of November, beginning of December, and now they've won three in a row. It's been a good year for the Bruins. Hookaboom. Quiet crowd here. Sellout crowd at the Garden. And Lowe is pulled down. Hines steals the puck and shoots and scores! And the Bruins lead 5-2. Lowe is taken down in center ice. Steve Hines jumped on the puck and gets his second of the game.
You know, one thing about Hines, his skating ability is the best part of his game. Let's see how the turnover occurred here. Lowe basically went down on his own as he tried to turn, and Hines has great speed. So he fights off the check with his legs spread, that of Amonte, and then slides a puck right underneath Van Beesbrouck, who was caught going down. Hines had a career in college full of injuries, yet when he's been able to play with the Bruins, he's been healthy and he's shown a lot of speed.
But even in college, when he was healthy, he was a very, very good scorer in Boston College.
Speed for a big man. And you can see the balance that he had as Amonte tried to strip him and pull him off balance.
Donato made the play on low. We have a whistle behind the play as the net has been knocked off the pegs and way out of the crease. Steve Hines unassisted with his second of the game, 11th of the season at 6:36.
It was a little tiny hook by Donato right there. However, it was more low turning than anything else that knocked him off balance. Look at the Hines. Watch him spread his legs. The balance kept, and then Van Beesbrouck got caught going right down. And when you're caught going down and the other team's player shoots, it's a tough position to be in, as you saw there, and the Bruins have a three-goal lead. This Boston Bruin team is really one to respect. Their work habits, their talent, they've changed with the times and deserve credit for what they've done this season. The Adams division has all of a sudden
become a terrific division. Wow. Buffalo playing a little bit better, even though they lost today. McGillney has 30 goals.
Quebec
is tough every night. Montreal, of course, even though Jacques Demers is now finding it tough to coach in Montreal.
Yeah, when you hit a little bit of a slump. Moog with a save on the point shot by Bukaboom. Bukaboom drives it on goal, saved by Moog. Might have deflected off his stick and off the post. 5-2 Boston with 12:30 to go in the third period.
Bukaboom sends it in.
Bork with a puck. Bruins with a win tonight would tie Montreal for first place in the Adams division. Moe got to stop the puck. Montreal and the Bruins still would have two games in hand. Montreal's played 37 games. This is Boston's 35th. Zubov, Nemchinov, fanned on the pass. Then he moves it around to Zubov. Erickson tied up by Oates. Across the line comes Patrick. Gartner heading for the net. Patrick turns, saved by Moog. In good position. Patrick with a tough low shot. Moog able to make the save. 11:34 to go, third period. Detroit with a lead in Chicago.
And he's right about Detroit getting hot. Mm-hmm. First time all season. There's a hit from behind on Kovalov.
And a penalty upcoming.
To Donato.
Wait, challenging Donato.
Donato will go. It'll be a hitting from behind penalty. Kovalov was all right. He bounced right back up quickly. Power play Rangers.
Ted Donato goes off. 8 minutes exactly remaining in the third. And since the early stage, Rangers have had just a few brief moments of excitement here. The penalty killing when they were down two men early in the game, and they killed off the 5-on-3 Boston advantage. The goal by Amonte and the goal by Kovalov, and that's been it.
Yeah, Boston's played strong all game long. See, Kovalov will turn. Actually, here's the play. He gets up, and then there's a hit from behind, driving Kovalov into the board, shoulder first. And Donato gets called.
Boarding is the call on Ted Donato at 12 minutes. And the Rangers have their fifth power play of the game. They are 0-for-4. Turcotte, Gartner, Amonte, Patrick, and Zubov. Amonte with the puck. Bouncing puck stopped by Moog. Shaw and Don Sweeney, Dave Poulin and Dave Reed for Boston. Dave Reed's got the puck. He has a shorthanded goal in the game. Boston with a shorthanded goal by Reed, a power play goal by Oates. Part of the five-goal explosion. Double team hit by Zubov and Turcotte. Patrick trying to take it away from Reed. Turcotte blocked by Poulin, looking for a steal.
Pretty good penalty killing. Reed and Poulin as a pair. They got it done.
Rangers won for their last 32 on the power play. Amonte plays it across. Turcotte off the boards. Swings it around for Gartner. Don Sweeney is there. Back to Amonte in the corner. Sweeney is there. Oates couldn't clear. Long shot by Hrovat. Saved by Moog. Zubov gets to the puck. For Amonte. Back to Zubov. Zubov toward the net. Amonte stops it for Gartner. Scores! On a beautiful pass from Amonte, Gartner tips it in. It's a power play goal. And now Mike Gartner is all by himself in eighth place all time in the National Hockey League with 557 goals.
Johnny Bilsik, one of the great Bruins, always around the goal net, finishes the play there. That was a goal against the Rangers. Johnny a few pounds lighter as he darts up the ice. This is against St. Louis Blues. Moves in past one of the Plagers. Red Berenson. I think that's Ernie Wakely in goal. And the goal. Now Mark Gartner scoring here on the power play.
Two great passes, Zubov to Amonte to Gartner. And Gartner moves into number eight, and he's sneaking up on Guy Lafleur, only three behind him.
And maybe Mike Bossy is reachable this season as well.
Gartner gets the goal, assisted by Amonte and Zubov. And for Sergei Zubov, that is his first NHL point. And here's a chance for a break. Alexei Kovalov on Moog. He scores! It's 5-4. The Rangers are back in it with 6:15 to go.
Alexei Kovalov can make goaltenders look like pretzels. Can he move? He turns goaltenders backwards. Doug Waite feeds the puck. Kovalov has room. The bench is standing. Both of them. Now watch the moves. One side to the other. Andy Moog is twisted around. Kovalov scores. 5-4. Rangers are within one. Watch Kovalov look up. One side. Andy Moog's gone. Open side. Kovalov scores. Oh, talk about excitement all of a sudden.
You know, I saw somebody go to the bench and say, John Davidson says it's a one-goal game. Well, Rangers score two, and it's a one-goal game.
I think Boston's called a timeout here as the Rangers have struck quickly.
The Bruins, in the first period, scored two goals in 9 seconds. Right here, the Rangers score two goals in 26 seconds. Gartner with his 19th from Amonte and Zubov at 13-19. The power play goal made it 5-3. And Kovalov with his second and his 10th of the season from Wade and Graves at 13-45.
It's a power play here. Zubov with a beautiful pass to Amonte. And watch this one. He gets a defenseman coming to him, elevates the puck, and Gartner got the puck up over top of Andy Moog. Tony Amonte had to knock the puck down and then find a way to get the puck over top of the defenseman's stick. He did it. And Mike Gartner scored to get the Rangers going again. And then Kovalov, Mr. Excitement. We've said it all game long. He's been the best Ranger. And man, did he make it look easy.
And the building is alive. The Ranger fans back in it. The Rangers have rallied to get to within one. Do they have enough to get back all the way? It is 5-4. Two goals in 26 seconds. Alexei Kovalov. He is turning into the human highlight film. Waite, Graves, and Kovalov with Bukubom and Lowe. Wesley fires it around the boards. 5-4 Boston with 6 minutes remaining. Waite reaches in, lifts the puck clear, knocked down by Ray Moore. And Kovalov was breaking out, and Kovalov knocked down Moore.
Oh, did he get hit? Kovalov and Graves, and he was sandwiched.
Oh, man.
He went down heavily, and now the Bruins trying to get at Kovalov. They're all trying to get at him. Now from behind, Kovalov took his own helmet off. Bork is still down being attended to. A number of the Bruins went at Kovalov. Kovalov took his gloves off, then he took his own helmet off. Ray Bork is dazed. Kovalov nailed Bork, blindsided him. Into Graves and Jeff Bukubom. Rangers want to be careful here. This is the best, you know, the Kovalov line has done well with Doug Waite on it and Adam Graves. So now what will Dvorsky call? You can see Graves is, or pardon me, Ray Bork. You can see he's been dazed. Kovalov after the opening faceoff, watch how he's picked up.
That's Brent Hughes on
and
him.
Hughes is on him, picking him up. Kovalov battles to get away. Now you hear the players from the bench yelling. Now watch Kovalov move in on Bork. Hard hit from the side. Bork had shot the puck into the zone. It was almost deep in the Rangers zone. He was not expecting the hit. The hit was not high. It may have been a touch late. But the elbow and the stick was down. Bork just didn't expect it. He was not prepared for that hit whatsoever. Graves and Kovalov in the box.
Roger Nielsen looks like...
Well, this is the call of the game right here.
Roger Nielsen looks like the Rangers... Well, Colin Campbell says it's going to be a wash.
Well, maybe they're hoping for a wash.
Paul Dvorsky is at the official scorer's table.
I haven't seen yet who is in the... Bruin penalty box as of yet. Kovalov now looks like he's getting ejected, maybe. Or maybe nothing, one or the other. Ejected.
Bruins will have a power play.
Now Kovalov,
yeah, he didn't get a penalty. What do you
have an equipment problem?
I don't think he didn't do anything wrong. He doesn't understand the language.
Okay.
What did he do? He hit Bork, perhaps a touch late. The stick and the elbow was down.
It's 2 minutes each for Graves and Donato.
Yeah.
That's it.
I like the way it's called, personally, because the players now can decide the game. Bork's unhappy. Now look at the puck's been shot in. Bork turns, the elbow's down and the stick's down. But it was maybe it was Graves from the other side. I never thought about that.
Yeah, but Graves got called for roughing. And that roughing call. Graves and Donato, 2 minutes each for roughing at 14:06.
No, I was trying to say, Sam, though, was why that Bork got hurt on the play. Maybe it was the hit from Graves.
More
than Kovalov.
And then Chinov moving in with a puck as the team skate four aside. And then Chinov shoots and it's blocked by David Shaw. Out comes Joey Junot. Junot with Oates, Shaw, and Sweeney for Boston. Zubov, Patrick, Nemchinov, and Gartner for the Rangers. Gartner gets to the puck. 5-4 Boston. 5.5 minutes to go in the third. Gartner circles back. Sees some open ice. Gets it across to Zubov. Back for Gartner. Pass in the slot. Knocked away from Patrick. He goes sliding into the net. Bruins move down 3-on-2. Adam Oates with Nemchinov back in a defensive role. Set up for Junot. Save Van Beesbrouck. Junot along the boards, tied up, and then Chinov has the puck. Outlets to Gartner. Boston changing. Gartner moving. Gartner, big drive. Knocked away from the blocker by Moog with 5 minutes to go in the third. The team skating far side. This will be an icing on the Bruins.
The wild action. 4-on-4. James Patrick got caught inside the Boston net. That meant it was a 4-on-3, and the fourth man up ice for Boston got the shot on goal. Van Beesbrouck the save. Now Roger Nielsen looks as Bork is back on the ice. What will the Bruins do with Kovalov? Remember, it's a one-goal game. Both teams have to try and keep their tempers in check, stay focused with the game. And this is developed into, because of two late goals by the Rangers, into a real good finish.
That's Sergei Nemchinov, a close-up look. 4:52 remaining in the third. Turcotte is out with Amonte. Lowe and Bukaboom, excuse me. Yes, it is Bukaboom for the Rangers. Poulin takes the draw against Darren Turcotte. 12 goals scored by the Rangers, 4-on-4 this season, 2 given up. Dave Reed chasing after the puck. Bukaboom able to get it to Amonte. Reed and Poulin with Bork and Wesley for Boston, and 4:40 remaining in the third. 5-4, Bruins lead it. Broken up in center ice by Wesley. Bukaboom with the hit on Reed. Lowe slides it across to Turcotte.
These two forwards for Boston kill penalties together. They're on the ice in a defensive role first.
Great neutral zone work by the Bruins. Reed to Wesley. Shot blocked by a sliding Amonte. Turcotte moving out. 3-on-3. Turcotte behind the back to Lowe. Lowe stood up by Wesley. Takes him out of the play. Bork plays the puck. 4:10 to go in the third. Dave Poulin moves in on James Patrick. Cuts in and shoots. Save Van Beesbrouck. Amonte there for the rebound. Moves it away from Reed, but Bork plays it. Bork against Kevin Lowe. Lowe holding on. Bork using his strength. Stays with the puck.
Rangers need Kovalov on the ice again.
Oates shoots. And Van Beesbrouck got a piece of it. Teams are back in full strength. 5 skaters aside. With 3:45 to go in the third. 5-4, Boston leading it. Steve Leach checked by Adam Oates, who hauls him down. And a whistle for an offside on the play. 3:42 to go in the third. 5-4, Bruins lead it. Alexei Kovalov on for the first time since the collision with Ray Bork. He scored 2 goals in the game. Puck bounces off the boards, and Van Beesbrouck able to get a stick on it. Patrick looks up ice.
Tell you, Oates is on with defensive wingers now with a 1-goal Boston lead. Kovalov will have to battle to get loose.
Wait. Kovalov and Graves. Wait, checked along the boards by David Shaw. Stays with the puck in the corner. He's hit from behind by Shaw. Puck moves up the boards by the Bruins. And out comes Junot. He was bumped by Kovalov.
Correction. The player Bartolnov is off the ice, and Leach is on in a defensive role.
Oates with a steal. Quick hands, but we've got penalties across the ice.
Junot along with Kovalov. Junot was, I think, clipped earlier by Doug Waite on the same shift, and he's hurting. And now Kovalov and Junot, two fine players, go to the penalty box. Junot was always noted as an offensive player. However, last year playing with Dave King,
Now Leach and Graves want one another. They're playing under Dave King with the Canadian Olympic team. Juno is a pure hockey player offensively and defensively. Leach was on the ice in place of Kartolnov, or Vartolnov, pardon me, K-Car, as they say, for the defensive purpose.
Steve Leach had a go with Mark Jansons last night in Hartford. 3:08 remaining in the third period. Kovalov and Juno, 2 minutes each. Once again, they'll skate four aside. High sticking for each.
See, this is Waite moving in on Juno. And there you see Juno meeting with Kovalov. They went back at one another. Juno tried to stay tight to Kovalov. And you saw Kovalov, the Bruins respecting his talents here, trying to make sure they either get him in the penalty box or mark him closely. Now the Rangers without Kovalov and only 3:08 remaining to try and tie it up.
2 minutes each for high sticking. Low and Bukaboom. Pass in front for Poulin. Just couldn't handle it. Poulin checked by Bukaboom. Low and Bukaboom. Nemchinov and Gardner for the Rangers. Poulin and Reed. Wesley and Bork for the Bruins. And Beesbrook pushes it up the boards for Nemchinov. 2:45 to go on the third. 5-4, Boston leading it. Great pressure. Poulin got tripped up by his own man. Bukaboom clears the zone, but the Bruins will recover.
It's that twosome up front with the 4-on-4 for the Bruins. Poulin and Reed, both times they've had shifts and 4-on-4s here late in the third. The Rangers haven't gotten over center ice.
Moog stops the puck. 2:25 to go. Up the board, skating four aside for another minute 15. Ted Donato plays it deep into the Rangers zone. Bukaboom and Donato go for it. Kevin Lowe moves up with it. Slides it out to Gartner. On to Bukaboom. Into the corner. Nemchinov goes after it. Don Sweeney is there. Centered for Gartner. Oh. He scores! Hey. What a play! Nemchinov to Gartner. It's 5-5.
Rangers better make a decision. They got five players on the ice. That includes Patrick and Bukaboom who are at the bench. And the other three players, Gartner, Nemchinov, and Zubac.
Wow, what a shot this is.
Yeah, what a pass. Dump in and a smart one. Watch the pass and then the shot. Rocket. 5-5, 2:03 remaining. Mike Gartner gets two goals late in the third. He steps into it. Beautiful shot off a beautiful pass from Sergei Nemchinov off the dump in by Zubac. And the Rangers have tied it up.
5-5, the Rangers with three goals in a span of 4 minutes and 38 seconds. Gartner, Kovalov, and Gartner again. Gartner is 20th from Nemchinov and Bukaboom. Here's a chance for Turcotte. Save made by Moog. Oates has the puck. 40 seconds to go in the 4-on-4. Rangers' 13th goal this season, 4-on-4. They love it.
Yeah.
Forget the power play.
Yeah, the climb.
That assist, by the way, the dump in was by Bukaboom, not Zubov.
Turcotte to Zubov. The crowd alive. The Rangers rallying from three goals down to tie it. This will be an icing. Shaw with a touch. 1:23 to go in the third period. Mike Gartner with two goals, his 19th and 20th, now has 5:58 lifetime. Yes.
November 7th, the Rangers had a 2-0 lead. Donato scored at 14:19 of the third. Bartolnov scored at 17:07 to tie it up at 2. It went to overtime. Rangers outshot Boston 6-2 in overtime but couldn't score. Now in this game, Boston enjoyed a 3-goal lead late, and all of a sudden an explosion with emotion for the Rangers. It's tied at 5. Scoring chance. Andy Moog was there as Turcotte took the rocket from the top of the circle.
Roger Nielsen pacing behind the bench.
He's trying to make sure his team has a proper alignment. Remember, Bork hasn't played much. Gillen hasn't played much in recent games, so the Rangers are making sure they know where to go. On the draw, 4-on-4. Oates opposite Gillen. Oates wins it.
Wesley, long shot, save Van Beesbrook. He's got it, gets the whistle.
He had ideas.
No, he wasn't going to stick handle.
Oh, no, never tongue. Said that.
You see in front, though, there was nobody there. Van Beesbrook had an easy time of making the save.
Look at this. And if he reaches 30, he'll be the first player ever to do it in 14 consecutive seasons.
30. If he plays and he's healthy, he'll reach 30.
What a marvelous, marvelous player.
The Bruins, Oates wins the draw back to, as you see, Ray Bourque. Now, the Rangers make sure in a defensive posture that there's nobody in front, and Van Beesbrook has an easy time Gillen with the point shot.
Gillen won the faceoff. He's got the puck. And it 10 to go in regulation time. Teams are back in full strength on the ice. Kovalov, oh, he slammed into by Juno.
It's a good hit, a real good hit by Juno.
Less than a minute to go in regulation time. 5-5 the score. The Bruins led 5-2. The Rangers have rallied to tie. Doug Waite moving in, looks around, shoots, save Morgan, he's got it.
Oh, look at Kovalov move in, and he gave Wesley a good shot. Kovalov has played with spirit here, folks. You gotta love it.
That looks to be Phil Bourque, I believe, in the middle of the pack and going at Ray Bourque. Yep.
There was an opening between the legs of Moog. Doug Waite was thinking pass to Kovalov. Then he saw he had some room, moved in, and Moog made the save. Kovalov went to the net, and he went in aggressively. He's handing it out. He's taking it. Here's one he took. Oh, beautiful hit. Great hit by Juno out of the box. Kovalov was looking at the puck. Bang. Now Waite moves in. He looks to his right because Kovalov is there. Now he leans in, takes the shot, watch Kovalov come in. He doesn't care. Boom, back goes Wesley. And that's because Kovalov was in front. Look at the right hand there.
Bourque on Ray.
Look at Kovalov come in. Man, is he playing an aggressive game. Gotta love it.
46.6 seconds remaining in regulation time as Don Sweeney and Alexei Kovalov go face to face. Prior to the dropping of the puck, Dave Reed is there. A little discussion goes on.
Poulin taking the defensive draw, the big draw. Poulin, the defensive center.
Doug Waite,
strong season.
12-7 on faceoffs. Dave Poulin 6-9.
See, Kovalov has moved back from the hash mark. In case Waite draws the puck back to him, he's open. He can make a play.
Stand off in the circle, pushed ahead. David Shaw sends it around the boards. 40 seconds remaining. Zubov pinching to keep it in. Waite centers off the skate. Shot save, rebound save, rebound score! Kovalov! Alexei Kovalov with a hat trick! The Rangers lead 6-5! The first hat trick in Alexei Kovalov's NHL career.
Young man's played his finest game in his young career. Kovalov, in just his 25th NHL game, has put on a show, and he has taken some hits, he has given some hits, he has shown a great tenacity that's been needed here. You see the Rangers battle to keep the puck in the zone. One shot, two shots, and then a third one. Kovalov snaps the puck over the goal line, and the Ranger fans are dancing in the seats. Man, are they celebrating. One, two, three shots to get the sixth goal. Kovalov celebrates, and he's a fan favorite here tonight. So excited. What a game.
What a comeback by the New York Rangers.
I don't know who that was. Was it Zubov that pinned to keep the puck
Zubov
in the zone?
Yes.
What a play that was to keep the play alive.
I have to tell you something, John. Another man who's played a great game tonight is
Doug Waite
has been superb.
We mentioned it throughout the game how that line was going. And Roger Nielsen, knowing that Messier was out with a flu, kept going with him. Oh, I'll take a few of that.
Neil Smith watching.
Dan Maloney. Remember the agony we saw before. The agony we saw earlier on Neil Smith's face has disappeared.
Oh, now, he'll be smiling all the way to Sweden.
Nice to celebrate. There's 35.9 seconds left here. There's still a Ray Bourque. There's an Adam Oates. There's Joey Junos. There's some skill on the other side. Watch out. Zubov with a great pinch.
great pitch to make the play.
Zubov with his first two NHL points. First NHL hat trick for Alexei Kovalov. Al Troutwig is downstairs. It must be bedlam down there, Al.
Well, Sam, it's an awful lot of fun, but you know what's even better? Fans threw their hats on the ice, and then after they were collected by Joe the Equipment Man, they started showing up. They wanted him back.
30 seconds remaining. Bork has the puck. 25 seconds remaining. Moog looking around. Lowe has the puck and sends it ahead. Rangers get into the Boston zone. They're offside.
20.2 seconds now remaining. Kevin Lowe with a smart play.
The Ranger goal. Alexei Kovalov with his third of the game, his 11th of the season, from Waite and Zuboff at 19:24. So the Rangers, in a span of 6 minutes and 5 seconds, scored 4 goals to take the lead.
Give the Rangers full credit here. Who would have thought it? They were down.
They were down.
They were out.
Building was quiet.
That's right. You know what happened, though? The power play got them a goal, got them back in it. The goal by Gartner on the power play got him back in, and all of a sudden, Kovalov. And who would have thought it, the way Boston was playing this game, correct? Credit to the Rangers.
Moog trying to get to the bench, can't get there. 12 seconds to go. Now he heads for the bench. Bruins in the Rangers zone. 10 seconds to go. Kuster's got the puck. Around the boards, it's blocked. Erickson clears the zone. The Rangers will win. What a comeback. The Rangers win 6-5 as Alexei Kovalov scores a hat trick.
What an emotional game. Highs and lows for both teams. For more than 18,000 fans, emotions high, emotions low. Alexei Kovalov in his first NHL year. He was on center stage, and what a show he came up with. Rangers come back to win it. This could be the win of the season for them.
Doug Waite, 3 assists. Mike Gartner with 2 huge goals in the third period. The Rangers outshot the Bruins 17-5 in the third, and John Van Beesbrouck made some important saves down the stretch. The Rangers smile as they head off, and Mr. Smith can now head for Sweden in the World Junior Championships, feeling good about the Rangers' win over the Boston Bruins 6-5. We'll be back with our post-game wrap-up in just a moment.